Hello everyone, so welcome to the third lecture on the course Ordinary Differential Equations. And today I am going to talk about the second method which will help you to solve any first order linear differential equation. In the last one we saw the method called as a variable separable method, but then as we saw that not all differential equation can be solved by variable separable. So then there is a second method which might help you to solve a first order linear differential equation. And what is that method? That method is called as reduction to variable separable method. Now before going to the method, let me tell you what are the objectives of today's talk. So at the end of this talk, you will be able to check whether the first order linear differential equation is a homogeneous differential equation or not, and how to use this method, reduction to variable separable method, to find the solutions of first order linear differential equations. So these two are the objectives. Okay, so now let me tell you two cases where you can always reduce your first order linear differential equation into a variable separable form. Okay, so before telling you these two cases, let me tell you two notations which you will often come across. So whenever you will start studying ordinary differential equation, the first thing you will come across is this thing. What does this represent? This means you have a function in x, y and y dash. It's an equation. So this is the equation, or you can say this is a differential equation of first order. For example, so this is a first order differential equation, right? If I bring this on the left hand side, what I get? This minus this equal to 0. This is what I get. Now if you see, this is nothing but this is an equation, or you can say left hand side is a function in x, y and dy by dx, or you can always replace this by y dash. So this is nothing but this is a left hand side is a function in x, y and y dash, and this is equal to 0. So this is the first thing which you will see more frequently whenever you will study a differential equation or first order differential equation. So this is one thing. The second notation that you will come across is this one. What you can do is, whenever you have a first order linear differential equation, you can always write it down in this form. That means what? You can take your dy by dx on one side and rest everything on another side, and whatever is there on the right hand side we call it as f of xy. So for example, suppose if I take this thing, what I can do? I can put this over here in the denominator, and what is your f of xy now? X4 plus y4 upon x3. So you can always do this for first order linear differential equation. If you take any non-linear first order differential equation, then you won't be able to do this. Okay, so this is only true for first order linear differential equations. Okay, so now let me tell you two cases where you can always reduce a first order linear differential equation into variable separable form. Among them, the case one. So whenever you see a differential equation of this form as in dy by dx equal to something, where here your x and y have degree 1 and a, b, c are what? They are some real numbers. Whenever you have a differential equation of this form, what you can do is you can always replace this thing by say variable u. You can always replace this by some variable u, and after doing this, whatever the differential you will get in u and x, that will be solved by variable separable method. Now let me take an example so that the method will be clear to you. So now suppose if you have these three differential equations. If you recall, in my last lecture, I gave you a homework problem in which this was the homework problem, and many of you solved and posted the answer in the comment section. So those who have not solved, they can see the solution from the comment section of my previous video and they can try to solve this question. Here if you observe, this thing is nothing but this. Your a is 1, b is 1, your c is 0. So what you can do is you can put this as u, and once you put this as u, you will be able to solve this question. I will be solving this question right now, and this I am giving you as a homework question. So make sure you solve this question and post the answer in the comment section. In this case, what you will do? You will put this as u and you will do by variable separable. Now let me do the second question for you. So this is our question. So what you do is you replace this term inside the bracket by u. So what I have you put 9 plus this plus 17 equal to u. When I differentiate both sides, 9 plus y dash equal to u dash. If I substitute this value over here, what is my y dash? It is nothing but u dash minus 9 equal to u square u dash means du by dx. So du by dx equal to u square plus 9. And now you can see, you can easily do variable separable. So this is nothing but du upon u square plus 9 equal to dx. And if I simply integrate both sides, what is this? If you know the formula, 1 upon 3 tan inverse of x by a. Right? This is nothing but 1 upon x square plus a square, which is 1 upon a tan inverse of x by a is equal to x plus c. You take 3 on the right hand side, take 10 on that side, and then again 3 on that side. So you have u equal to something. You will have u equal to and at the end you will replace your u by this thing. You will replace your u by this thing and you get your y equal to whatever the solution is. So this is how you can always reduce such kind of differential equation into variable separable with the help of a substitution. So I hope this example is clear. If not, you can again rewind the video and you can convince yourself. And if this is clear, make sure you solve the third example. Okay, after this, now let me tell you the second case where you can do such kind of things. The second case is called as a homogeneous differential equation. Well, this homogeneous word you will again encounter when you will study higher order differential equations or even when we study linear differential equation, but don't get confused. So now let me tell you what does this mean. So what does this say is, whenever you are able to write your first order linear differential equation in this way. So right hand side we had f of x comma y, right? And if you, instead of x comma y, you can only express it in only one variable. And what is that variable now? Y by x. If you can do this thing, then you can always substitute this thing as u, and then you will be able to reduce it to variable separable form. So this is the thing which you can do to reduce such kind of differential equation into variable separable form. Now let me take an example so that the whole thing will be clear. Let me take this example. So what does this example says? Dy by dx equal to 4x square plus y square upon xy. So can I write in terms of y upon x? Yes, if I divide numerator and denominator by x square, this is nothing but 4 plus y by x whole square upon y by x. So this is what I get if I divide both numerator and denominator by x square. And now you can see this is nothing but a function in terms of y by x. Now if you put your y by x equal to u, this means your y is nothing but u x. And now if I differentiate, both sides, u into derivative of x is 1 plus x into derivative of u is u dash. This is what I have. And when I substitute this and this in this equation, what I have u plus x u dash equal to 4 plus u square upon u. And now simply rearranging, you get the answer. So let's try to rearrange. So what you do is, you bring this u on the right hand side, which I did over here. By cross multiplication, I have minus u square and I get 4 upon u. And as you can see, this is much more easier to solve. What you have is, this is du by dx. So u du equal to 4 upon x dx. Voila. So you can see that this is nothing but in a variable separable form. Now you simply integrate, this is nothing but u square equal to 4 ln x plus c. You replace the value of u by x. So this is nothing but y square equal to x square into this whole thing. So this is what the solution is to the given differential equation. So that's how you can always solve homogeneous differential equation by reduction to variable separable. And what is homogeneous? If you can rewrite your right hand side in terms of y by x, if you can do that, great. You can always use this method. Now let me tell you a trick on when you can do such kind of things. Okay, see, if you have this kind of example, you just see whether each term is having same degree or not. Like here, this has a degree 2, this has a degree 2, and here this also has a degree 2. X has degree 1, y has degree 1, so total is degree 2. Whenever all the terms have same degree, you can always reduce this in the form f of y by x. As you can see, this is nothing but if I divide by x y over here, what I get? I get x upon y plus y upon x. simply divide by x square, separate your numerator and denominator, this is what you have. And now you replace your y by x by u, so 1 upon u plus u. And here you have u plus x u dash. U will get cancelled and you can easily solve this question. So just see whether all terms have same degree or not. If all terms have same degree, you can definitely reduce it to variable separable form using this kind of substitution. And if this is clear, let me give you one last example as a homework. Okay, so take this as a homework question. So here if you observe, all terms have degree 2. Degree 2, degree 2, degree 2. So definitely you can solve this by reduction to variable separable form. Keep y dash over here. Get this 2xy on the right hand side. Bring into the form y by x. Use the substitution. And again at the end, resubstitute. Do not forget to resubstitute the value of u as y by x. So this is a differential equation, and when you solve this, you get a general solution. Let me give you one initial condition. Suppose I tell you that y of 1 is 2. So once you solve this, you get a general solution, and then you replace your 1 by 2, your x by 1 and y by 2, you get the value of c. And that solution is called as a particular solution. So you find the general solution as well as the particular solution and comment both the solution in the comment section. And this together is called as what? If you recall my previous lecture, this is called as an initial value problem. So this, a differential equation together with an initial conditions, then such a problem is called as an initial value problem. So these are the two cases where you can always reduce your first order linear differential equation into a variable separable. So I hope both the cases are clear. Make sure you do both the homework questions and post the answer into the comment section. So I hope the session was clear. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section. I will try my best to answer your doubts. And do not forget to like, share and subscribe. Thank you.